You know those moments where you've got this outfit on and you think you look pretty snazzy and you're just about to head out the door and then you look down and you're like, wait, is this outfit terribly outdated? Today, I'm gonna talk about 10 of the most outdated pieces for 2021. Secrets of a Stylist. For those of you guys who don't know me, my name is Kim. I'm a fashion stylist at Brooklyn Zoo. Hello, I'm so excited to see you. Okay, let's get right into the video. First things first, I want to say I have made many of these mistakes. I've worn all of these outfits. This video is not for those of you who really don't care about trends. This is for the people that are like, I really want to know what is outdated. What shouldn't I be wearing anymore? I get those questions all the time. Some people really want to know and they don't want to wear those things. And some of you just don't care. But I'm guessing because you're watching me, it's a fashion channel and I'm a stylist and I'm here to give you all the tips. I'm guessing that you want to know. So anyway, I'm not trying to be rude. I'm just trying to like help a girl out. Okay, let's get into the video. First things first, one of the most outdated looks that is out there right now and one that I am so guilty of wearing for years and years is the tall riding boots with the skinny jeans and the long like mom sweater. Remember when those were cool? They had like long pockets and like, you know, it's a look. And if you know, you know, if you've worn it, that has been around for many years. It was very cool. I feel like in like 2007, maybe. Anyway, lots of people still doing it out there. So how can you update that? Okay, so let's talk about that. If you're gonna wear, let's take off the cardigan. Let's zip the cardigan up to something that's maybe a little shorter. So it's not that super long one that kind of touches your long flat riding boots. No, not that. So take it up shorter, wear a different one, a fun color. Maybe it's the green, the purples that are coming in for fall. Maybe you wanna keep it neutral and it's like a white or a black, but just keep it more to like a cropped cardigan that works for your body type instead of the long hanging one. If you wanna wear flat boots, if you wanna change out those tall riding boots, a pair of army boots are fantastic. Any pair of loafers, kind of like the chunky heels, those are in. Very fun. A pair of white runners, if it's still warm enough in your area to wear, those are fantastic. The second look that is very outdated, although admittedly, I still like to throw this on sometimes when I'm running around, it is like the leggings with the long tunic. Now I'm gonna go out there and just say like specifically the tunic shirt. I think this was literally like a mom uniform and then all of a sudden everyone started wearing it. It was like leggings, and I'm gonna go one step further and I'm gonna talk about the third piece, which is the t-shirts with like the uneven, irregular hem. So it kind of was like shorter in the front, and then it was like a handkerchief cut kind of, was pointed on the sides. So you got that t-shirt on, you got your leggings on, maybe your tall riding boots and your long sweater. Like, it's a whole thing. So anyway, the long tunic with the leggings, that's out. Try throwing on, instead of that, a pair of joggers. So I have a pair of camo joggers, so cute. Just as comfortable, throw those on with a longer t-shirt, very cute, pair of runners, army boots, loafers, whatever. But anyway, the leggings are still cool, but if you wanna update them, add a white pair of runners, maybe a jean shirt over a t-shirt. Like, that's still a great look if you're like wanting to run your kids around or you're running some other errands. But we're gonna stay away from the long tunic, long sweaters. No. If you love it though, hey, hey, you go for it. I'm just telling you what's actually not trending anymore. Okay, this one for sure. So all of those people, I know you're gonna be like panicked, don't panic, but it's the thing, it's just gone right now. They're gonna come back, you can save your shoes. But if you wanna know what's out of trend, it is not trendy anymore to wear a very round toed boots. Those were really trendy for a while, and the round toe ballet flats. Like, that is not a thing. Remember, like, I don't know, I had a very round pair. I think they were Tory Burch. And you know, they have the big logo on them. Like, I would wear those with my long sweater and my leggings. I thought I was looking super chic. Those are gone, round toe boots. And I'm gonna throw one more thing in with this, like round toe wedge boots. No, that just dates you. I think it screams dated. It does, it screams dated. And so how can you change that? The question is, how can you change that? More of an almond toe is a very neutral place to go. So if you like your ballet flats, an almond toe ballet flat. So that means it's like a little pointy. It's not round, it's not square, it's not super pointy. It's like very neutral. It's a perfect place to go with that. And then I'm gonna add on the wedge. So I'm gonna move from the round toe to the wedge. So wedge boots, those were like seriously a thing. And so they are not anymore. I find the same thing. I have wedge sandals, I like them. I have a beautiful pair of like espadrille wedge Valentinos. I love those. Depending on the shoe, I do find the wedge, if it's not worn in the right way, in the right location, with the right outfit, it can really, really date you. So wedge, let's go specifically with wedge boots, because I still think wedge sandals have a place. So wedge boots, that is very dated, so you want to kind of stay away from those. Again, go for a defined heel. So if you don't want to wear a pointy heel, a big chunky heel, those are fabulous, easy to walk in, you look fantastic with an almond toe. You got this. The next thing on my list, and I have talked about this in one of my other videos, and I get lots of feedback and everyone's like, I don't like that. But I'm just saying, if you want to know what's on trend, this is what is not on trend. And it is the cutout cold shoulder shirts. So I only ever bought one of these. I don't know, I just didn't really like it. I bought this one, this was like so bad. It was a cold shoulder sweatshirt, and it had like little like cartoon things all over. It was so hideous. Okay, so anyway, cold shoulder, not good. It is not trending anymore. If you love your cold shoulder and you're like, I feel like I look beautiful in it, then you definitely wear it. Just giving the information of what is not trending right now. Okay, coming in next and coming in hot right after the cold shoulder shirts is the knotted shirts. So, and the knotted and the twist, and I find the twist and the knot like hangs too low. And I don't know where this trend came from. Again, this was not something that I really had, because I'm like, well, I like to knot my shirts myself because I kind of know where to put the knot and also how tight to tie it. And I don't know, they always just felt a little cheese to me. But anyway, so the knotted shirts, they are not trending. The ones that are pre-knotted or they kind of have a twist. However, I will say, if you know your body type and there is a type of shirt like that that really looks good on you, and you're like, I do not care about the trends. So for example, apple body types, a little twist to the side can sometimes actually look fantastic on you. It draws attention away. I think it's a great thing. But if you're wondering, if you have a bunch of stuff in your closet and you want to clean it out, and you're wondering, is this cool? Is it not? Is it trending? I'm just telling you, it's not. Another thing that is not trending anymore, and it was for a really long time, but I find when you wear it, it really dates you. Although it does have a place, so, you know, take this all with a grain of salt. But like, there was a time where like the midi skirt with a jean jacket and tank top was like the biggest thing. It's just like, doesn't look that good anymore. If you want to update that, like I can literally see that look and I know approximately what period that came from and when that trend was in its prime. It's still, you know what, if you're wearing a long skirt and it's nice out and you're on vacation, you got a tank top and you're bringing a jean jacket, fair, I like that. But I'm just saying, if you would like to update that look, a great way to do it is a blazer. Throw on a great blazer with that. Throw on a pair of loafers, some really cool sandals, definitely not flip-flops, depending if you're at the beach or not. But anyway, throw on a different type of jacket. It could be an army jacket, it could be a blazer. I think blazer or cardigan would be the most updated for that look, but stay away from like the floral midi skirt, tank top, jean jacket, it's done. So those are a few of like my really favorite not cool trends anymore, and like those looks that you just like were on Pinterest in like, I don't know, like 2012. Those things I think you could really update. Again, chuck in white sneakers, blazers, cardigans, some really cool things like that, new colors. And sometimes, even if you have classic pieces, just move them in your wardrobe, save them for later, because guess what? Everything comes back around again. Anyway, if you guys love this video, remember to say hi to me down below. Tell me what you liked. If there's a look, this has to be really funny comments. You guys have to talk to me in the comments. Tell me the looks that you think are the most dated. I would really like to read that. I wanna know from you guys around the world, what are the trends that are dying for you? I love you guys. Remember to hit the subscribe button and I will see you on the next video.